corruption is a real challenge in Africa. It's an expected thing in your relationships with the police, with the judiciary, going over to shops trying to buy anything. It's almost as though it's the very air that we breathe. And in the process, sadly, too many Christians, even genuine Christians, begin to accept that that must simply be a way of life. I think it's important for us, especially as African Christians, to recognize the fact that the Lord doesn't just save us for heaven. He also saves us in order for us to be salt and light in the world. And the point that the Lord Jesus Christ is making there is that we ought to be different. By speaking about us being salt, what he really means is that we are to be a means by which decay in society will be arrested. And let's face it, that's what corruption does. It undermines any form of truth and integrity, justice, fair play, and so on. Everything that we ought to value as human beings living together in a just society is undermined through that vice. What we Christians are called to do, therefore, is to ensure that by our lives we arrest that decay. But Jesus also says not just that we will be salt, but that we ought to be light as well in the world. As he puts it himself, that nobody lights a lamp and puts it under a bowl. That doesn't make sense. Instead, he puts it on the table, or in our case, he puts it on the ceiling so that everybody benefits from its light. That's who we are. So in the moment of temptation, always remember that you ought to be different. You ought to be a light shining in the darkness. You ought to speak a different message to a society and a community that has begun to see corruption as if it is normal. In the book of Ephesians, the Apostle Paul puts it this way to the believers there. In Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 20, this is what he says. But that is not the way you learned Christ, assuming that you've heard about him and were taught in him as the truth is in Jesus. To put off your old self, which belongs to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful desires. Now, clearly there, he's not just speaking about the corruption, about money exchanging hands. He is speaking about our very corrupt natures that we have been taught by the Christian faith to abandon that altogether and instead take on what is being renewed in us by God through Jesus Christ. But look further in chapter 5 and verse 7. Therefore, do not become partakers with them. For at one time you were darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of light is found in all that is good and right and true. And try to discern what is pleasing to the Lord. Listen to this. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them. That's our responsibility. And if we as Christians don't take this seriously, we are failing the Lord. Remember, Jesus Christ wants us to be salt and light in this world full of corruption. Oh, how I pray that one day historians will write that because we had Christians on the continent of Africa, corruption was challenged. Integrity instead became the order of the day. The two of us must make sure it happens, and that it happens soon.